very interesting task because it invites students to look at different dimensions of technology. But I wonder if this is going to lead to a process or an idea that is called technological determinism. The idea is that today we have mobile phones, laptops. We are, you know, destined to go towards certain kind of technology. As if humans have no control or thought processes or agency involved in shaping technology. Though you are flagging the idea of need, the need somehow just moves around, revolves around, you know, computer, gadgets and electronics. Whereas we had other groups which talked about agricultural evolution, we have groups about cultural evolution. Unfortunately, the balance with culture and technology, about society and technology, remains unreversible. So it would have been good if this predictive notion of technology, which is a major debate that is happening across the globe, technological determinism, shaping the world that is to be, is a really scary thing because it just makes people passive and technology active. So is there a conscious effort to actually bring this in this world?
So when I said there will be given four different articles, one of the articles is based on the social reasons, so where they talk about how society influences changes in technology, the pros and the cons, and then it also talks about why is it a factor. So here the content part has to be developed more. Since the time was limited and we thought we had to do many things there, we went ahead with the methodology part of it. So there is this also that I talked about.
Is there a critique of technology built in, for example, from each of these dimensions, from the social dimension,
yeah,
from the economic dimension, from the demographic one, and from the geography?
Right. Yeah. These are 10th graders.
Which go beyond the industrialization.
Yeah, I mean, they just know about industrialization, so I thought for their grade level, this would be already relevant in English. I never thought, you know, giving too much, would be too much of content for them to handle. So this was more to know that technology has a history. It's not what it is today, and it won't remain the same.
I was wondering if it's possible to take the discussion a little further than what is there in the textbook and do the reverse, impact of technology on society, economy, polity, etc. So we know that this is industrialization, this is how needs resulted in these technological advances. But if we see the impact, then we can bring in both the positive as well as the negative. So if the discussion could go a little further, and also look into the political economy of technology. There is this hierarchical thing that if you have this technology, then you are, you know, sort of controlling the world politics, so to speak. So looking at that, and as well as looking at impact of technology. So okay, fine, you've got your phones and you've got your this and that. So because of that, now what is the, suppose, for example, impact of social media on movements and things like that. So impact, the reverse, which is not in the book, but you know this has happened, so now look around you and see what is the impact of this advancement in technology. So do you have any
time's up? We can't let you rebut, the time's up.